So, except for last night, I always start with something else. We call the Hanumat Stovan. It's a prayer to Hanuman. Hanuman is, whether you believe in flying monkeys or not, I'm not sure if I do actually, but that's not what, that's not the real Hanuman. The real Hanuman is that connection between our individual soul and the great soul of all. It's that flow of grace, of love, that connects us all to the one of which we're all a part. Hanuman is worshipped as the destroyer of calamities, the remover of suffering, ocean of grace. It's like the 42nd Street shuttle. Used to be, not anymore, but used to be you got on Grand Central and you couldn't get off until 40, until the west side. Once you get on, that's it. You're in. No getting off. Now, of course, you can get off on Fifth Avenue, but don't do it. So when we bow to this flow of grace, we move more deeply into ourself, our true self. And there's a line in there. Which I can't remember. Only if I sing it, I can remember it. But it's the part that says, Ramadutam Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadye, which means I take refuge in the messenger of Ram. Ram being that one. But since we're not paying attention and our awareness is not subtle enough, we bow to the one who connects us to that place. The place is always there. It's our true nature. But we are facing in an outward direction. But the flow is always moving, you could say, inward. And so we take refuge, we take shelter in that love, which is itself the mist of the ocean of Ram. Pranavam Bhavanakuma Kalabana Pava Kagyanagam Jasuhradayaga Basiram Sarachapadhar Atulita Valadha Himashala Badeha Dinujavana Krishna Gyaninama Graganyam Sakalaguna Nidhana Vanarana Madhishan Raghupati Priya Bhaktam Vata Jatam Namam Goshpali Kirtanishan Mashiki Kritarakshasam Ramayana Mahamalaratnam Vande Nilatmajam Anjana Nandaram Dira Janaki Shokanashana Kapisa Makshahanta Vande Lanka Bhayankaram Yalanga Sindho Salilam Salila Yashoka Vahi Janakatma Jaya Adayatane Dadahalanka Amamitam Pranjali Ranjaneam Manojavam Marutatulya Vegam Jitendriyam Budhimatam Varishtam Vatatmajam Vanarayuta Mukhyam Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Shri Ramadutam Sharanam Prapadhe Anjaneya Mukti Patalana Kanchanadri Kamaniya Vigraham Parijata Taramula Vasana Bhavayami Pavamananandanam Yatra Yatra Raghunath Kirtana Tatra Tatra Kritamasta Kanjali Vashpavari Paripurna Lochana Martinamat Rakshasantakam Bolabajaranga Bali Hanuman Ki Jai. Hare Rama, 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 Sita Rama, Rama, Rama. Hare Rama, 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 Sita. Thank you.
Sita Rama Rama Rama.
foolish heart, why do you weep? You've thrown yourself away again. Now you cry yourself to sleep. Cry yourself to sleep. My foolish heart, when will you learn? You are the eyes of the world, and there's nowhere else to turn. To turn. But you go up and down. But you go up and down. But you go up and down. My foolish heart. Govinda, Govinda, my foolish heart, my foolish heart. Foolish heart. Radhe, Radhe, Govinda, Govinda. Yeah.
Govinda,
Do you know what Bhaja Govinda means? You can leave. So Bhaja, this what we just sang is a perversion of a very great hymn written by Shankaracharya. He was walking down the street one day with some of his disciples, and he saw an old man sitting on the side of the road who was teaching Sanskrit grammar to a group of young boys, I believe it was at the time. And being a great saint, he could see that this old guy was going to die very soon, and that he'd spent his whole life doing external things and never doing any practice, any real practice, anything to help himself. He was just like a school teacher. So out of compassion, he went up to him and he said, "Oh, my friend, Bhaja Govindam." Bhaja means to sing or praise or remember, and Govinda is the name of Krishna. He was saying like, "You're out of here, dude, do something." And then he went home that night and he wrote this long, beautiful hymn. And there's a recording of it by a woman named Subbulakshmi, which is so extraordinary. So the chorus is Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, my foolish mind, a foolish heart. And then the verse would describe one of the many ways that we just, our lives just pass us by without us paying attention at all. And then back to the chorus, back, it was very beautiful, very deep. So that's that. Shankaracharya was one of these really extraordinarily incredible beings. He became the like the guru of all of India. He traveled all around India and he would debate with people of different ideologies. And these debates were serious. They were like, because before the debate, you had to agree that if you lost the debate, you would become a follower of the other person. So it was serious shit. You were putting your life on the line. And he won every debate. The philosophies are so subtle and so deep. I have no, you know, I don't have really much of an understanding of it all, but he was, never mind. But anyhow, so one hunt, this is really cool. So he was traveling around and there was one really, really great teacher, acharya, named Madan Mohan Mishra, who was a tantrika, and who was, Shankaracharya was mostly what they call a non-dual. But of course he wrote all these devotional hymns too, so. So there was this one guy who, there's two stories. So one story said there's one guy whose wife was actually the goddess Saraswati, this other guy. And so Shankaracharya went up there. Now, he was a monk ever since he was a kid. And they went up there and they started this debate, this contest, you know, intellectual, philosophical context. And of course, they had first agreed that whoever won would surrender, the other person would surrender to them. So Madan, this other guy, was about to lose when his wife counseled him to open the debate about tantric sexual practices, which Shankaracharya didn't have a clue. He was a monk ever since he's a boy. So so he called time out. And he went off to figure out what to do. That was allowed. You were allowed to have timeouts, you know.
Three timeouts.
Huh?
Three timeouts.
Three timeouts only?
Okay. Yeah.
And so what he did was he went into this cave. He had some of his disciples with him. And he went into this cave and he ascertained that there was this king that was going to die, ready to die. He was going to die very soon. And so he went into some kind of a samadhi, trance. And when the king left his body, Shankaracharya entered into his body just at that moment. So now Shankaracharya is a king with a harem. Party time. And so, and he had instructed his disciples to guard this cave that he was hiding. And so all these other people were going around trying to find this cave to kill him before he could re-enter his body. But they guarded the cave. The problem was, as you might imagine, Shankaracharya started to like being a king. He got a little bit lost there. And one, I think one of his really advanced disciples kind of went to see him psychically and said, "Hey, dude, you know, you got this thing going on over here with this other guy. You better come back to your body." And he, "Oh, yeah, right, okay." But it wasn't easy. So he came back into the body, and then he went back to the debate, and he won the debate. But there's another story, too. I'm not sure if it was on the way to this debate, but he was going through the mountains on the way to debate somebody. And he got real sick, really sick. And he got sicker and sicker, and he couldn't move anymore. He just laid down. He could barely move, and he's really sick. He was like going to die. And he was losing consciousness and just being out for a long period of time. So all of a sudden, he felt some water sprinkled on his face. And he opened his eyes. And there's this beautiful young girl, like 8 years old, looking at him and sprinkling water on his face. And then he passed out again. And then after some time, he came to again, and she was still there. And at one point, she says to him, "Baba, what's wrong?" And he said, in a typical way of speaking, he was to say he was so weak and he couldn't, had no strength, he said, "No Shakti." So this little 8-year-old girl looked at him and she transformed into the goddess. And she says, "But you don't believe in Shakti." Because he was, at that time, he was very, it's hard to understand, but non-dual stuff. Didn't believe in like any kind of manifestations or in just the ultimate one, only one. So, and she sprinkled him again and she disappeared and he woke up and he was completely cured. And he wrote this incredible hymn that Mr. Tiwari, my Indian father, used to sing all the time. And it's called the Devya Aparada Kshama Pana Stotram. which means the prayer begging the goddess for forgiveness is really something. And each verse says, because he was a man writing it, the chorus of each verse says, you know, a bad son might be born, but never a bad mother. And then it gone on, I don't know this, I don't know how to pray, I don't know how to do puja, I can't do any practice, I can't do, you know, but ma, all I know is that a bad son might be born, but never a bad mother. So, but you know, in the West, we don't think about things quite the way they do in the East. And we don't really have an appreciation for just being alive. Got so much stuff going on. We take it for granted that we're here, which ultimately is a mistake. Because they say it's not so easy to get a human body. People who know, not me. They say, in fact, what they say is, imagine the whole ocean, right? And imagine a seagull flying across the ocean, all around the ocean, indiscriminately, just flying, carrying a piece of silk cloth in its beak, right? Just above the surface of the ocean. And imagine that there's a turtle, a sea turtle that lives at the bottom of the sea, which comes up once every 100 years for a breath of air and then goes back down again. They say the chances of getting a human body after you die is the same as the chances of that turtle coming up and actually touching that piece of silk scarf that the seagull is flying all around the world endlessly. Not very good odds. So, but don't be afraid. Let's just keep being stupid. I don't know. If any of this stuff is true, it would be pretty interesting, huh? It's certainly, you know, it's a different perspective on life. You know, I grew up on Long Island. That pretty much counts me out. You know, we don't grow up with this wider perspective that there's something that goes on and that there's a reason to be here. Nobody in my family. There was one saint in my family, my aunt, Bella. And her qualifications for being a saint was that she never complained. That's a saint in my family. So, what are we going to do? Let's sing, eh? Don't have nightmares, unless you have to. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare
In the winter of 1971, we were in Vrindavan at Maharaji's temple. One of the Westerners that was hanging out with us had been in India a long time, and his name was Sadhu Ramdas, as opposed to Baba Ramdas. He's now the head of the Asian Philosophy Department, University of Hawaii, in Honolulu. So he knew at that time the people from the devotees from ISKCON, Hare Krishna people, were coming to India for the first time from the West, and he knew some of the big people in the movement, and he invited the guy to come and bring his disciples to sing, to chant in the temple. Now, at that point, we used to sing to Maharaji because he liked it, but it was kind of more like, Shri Ram Jai Jai. That kind of puts you to sleep, you know. So they came to the temple and they brought their drums, their clangers and bangers, you know, and they were rocking and rolling. And I was standing next to Maharaji, and he turned and he looked at me and goes, Hare Krishna, Maha Mantra. Telling me a big secret, you know? So they left after a while, and he reaches into his dhoti, and he pulls out a 50 rupee note, and he hands it to me and says, go buy a drum. That's how all this started. Oh. 50 rupees only. And then the next day I went back, I didn't play it. I wanted him to play it first. So I brought it back, I gave it to him, and he went, ah, like this, you know. He said, who's going to teach you how to play? I said, Hanuman. He said, okay, so that's why I don't play drums. But, yeah. Let's do this mantra to Hanuman. With Om Hum Hanumate Namaha. Om Hum Hanumate Namaha. So hum, not ham, but ha, hum, hum, and Hanumate ha nu ma te, not Hanumate. It's like the Ramayana, you know. It's the Ramayana. Ramayana, that's the way Americans, Westerners say. Hanumate, Hanumate, Hanumate. Om Hum Hanumate Nama. Okay? So we'll sing it all together. Thank you. Radhe, Amaha, Om Hanumate, Om Hanumate, Om Hanumate.
Shiva.
Shiva.
Shivaya Namaha. Shivaya Namaha. Calling out to hungry hearts everywhere through endless time. You who wander, you who thirst, I offer you this Bodhi mind. Calling out hungry spirits everywhere through endless time. Calling out hungry hearts, all the lost and the left behind. Gather around and share this meal, your joy and your sorrow, I make it mine. Calling out to hungry hearts everywhere through endless time. You who wander, you who thirst, I offer you this heart of mine. Calling out hungry spirits everywhere through endless time. Calling out hungry hearts, all the lost and the left behind. Gather around and share this meal, your joy and your sorrow, I make it mine. Shri Guru Charana Sarojaraja Jamanam Kur Siddhari Barano Ragubara Demala Jasu Jodayak Halachari Buddhi Tanujanke Sumiram Avan Kumar Siyaram Bala Buddhi Vidya Dehu Mohin Haru Kalis Dikar Savara Ramachanda Pada Jesharanam Jaya Hanuman Kyana Gunasa Jaya Kabisati Loka Ujjani Ramaduta Turta Baladhama Anjani Putta Pavana Sutana Jarangi Kumat Nivar Sumati Kesangi Kanchana Varana Viraja Subesa Kanama Kumbala Kumchita Kesa Atta Bajarara Dvaja Viraja Kande Munja Jane Usaja Nkara Suvana Kesari Nanda Japrata Mahajagat Vidyavan Guni Ati Chato Ramakaja Karima. Mantra Sunibe Korasi Dama Lakana Sita Manavasi Sukshma Rupa Darasiya Hindika Nikata Rupa Darevanka Chara Nima Rupa Daresur Sahare Ramachan Kekata Sama Daya Sajivana Lakana Jiyai Nila Kuvira Harashira Dalai Raghupati Kini Bohut Sambhavai Sarasabhadam Tumaro Chasaka Asakai Shri Pati Kantalaga Samikadika Brahmadi Munis Marata Sharada Saita Adis Makubera Digapala Jahante Obindakai Sake Kahante Sugriva inkina rama melai raja padadi Tumaro mantra bibishanama Ankeshwarabai sarva jagajan Unga sahasra jojan parabanu liryotai Gura parajan Abhu murdrika melimukaman Sarajanahi Kurtama Kaja Jagat Kejeti Sugama Panugara Tumare Tete Dhamma Duwari Tumara Kavari Otana Agya Binu Pesari Sab Sukhlahe Tumari Sharana Tumara Chak Kahu Kodala Apana Teja Samaro Ape Ino Loka Hapka Tinkante Buddha Desashana Kata Mahi Ave Mahavir Chabanama Suna Hasero Gahare Sabatir Chapata Nirantara Hanumatabir Sankata Churave, manakama bachanatam na jolave Sabapanarama tapasvi raja Inake kaja sakalatum saja Oramanorata joko elave Sove amit vihana parapam Charon yunga paratapatuma Eparasi Jagata Vijaya Sadhu Santa Ke Tumar Kovare Asura Nikandana Rama Dulare Ashta Siddhi No Nidike Data Asubhara Dina Janki Mata Rama Rasayana Tumare Pasa Sadaro Ho Prabhupati Ke Dasa Tumare Anta kala ragu bhar pura jai Jahan jan hare bhakta jai Aur devata chittan dare Hanumat se sarav sukh kare Sankat kate mite sab pira Jo sumire Hanumat balir Jai Hanuman Gosai Kripa Karo Gurudev Kina Jo Satvara Parta Kar Koi Chuta Hi Bani Mahasukho Hoi Jaya Pare Hanuman Chalisa Hoya Siddhi Sakhi Garisa Tulasi Dasa Sada Hari Chera Sita Sahita
Might be possible to live in this world in a good way, with an open heart, without fear. It's only because of the great beings that have gone before us on this path. Out of their love, out of their kindness, they left some footprints for us to follow. So, in the same way that they wish for us, in the same way that they wish for us, we wish that all beings everywhere, all of us, be safe, that all of us be happy, that all of us have good health and enough to eat. And may we all live in peace. And that ease of heart, with whatever comes to us in life. Shanti means peace. Peace beyond understanding. When we know who we are, when we live in the love that lives within us, then we are peace. May we all be that. As we say in India, vaya con Dios. Sleep well. Somebody will see somebody sometime tomorrow.